The site of this assignment is Lobei Village, which is located in the Xiangcheng District, Suzhou, Jiangsu Province. Specifically, the downtown area lies off the southwest part of our site. The subcenter in Xiangcheng District shares the boundary in the north. The northeast corner is Yangcheng Lake. Moreover, Suzhou Industrial Park is located in the southeast of the site. Currently, there are 3,270 permanent residents and about 19,000 migrants living inside. The site occupies the land of 3.87 square kilometers. In 2003, three original villages, Lobei, Huxiao, and Caozhuang, were combined into a new village, namely Lobei Village at present. As indicated by the locals, around the 1940s, this area used to be a natural village, which owned large amount of cultivated lands and abundant water resource. With the urbanization proceeded, during 1960s, two fertilizer plants were set up and some basic commerce and supporting facilities formed gradually. After 1980, a factory cluster was established in the north, which reduced the original farming lands greatly. Then, some elevated roads were constructed around the site. Thus, the traffic conditions and accessibility became more complicated. Firstly, the residential use is dominant in this site. In the middle part, a street market provides retail service. Industrial use could be identified usually in this area. A primary school is between the residential buildings and nearby the street market. The national road and elevated roads just bring great traffic flows. The traffic conditions inside are complicated and lack of order. In terms of the blue and green infrastructure, there are large amount of greening around the elevated road. Lots of vacant fields are existing inside. Water resource is unsystematic in the site. An abandoned prison is located in the site. Several buildings of a huge volume with high walls just cause the segregation. Perhaps the function transfer is needed. The street market is an attractive view here, which is lively and natural. Infrastructures are unsatisfied. Its development lacks of effective management and order. Factories usually have bigger volume and gather in this site. The architecture style and features such as color and material are different with other fabrics. Close to the water, the dwellings are preserved partly. Some renewal constructions were completed spontaneously, which damaged the original landscape to some extent. According to the Suzhou strategic plan, the water system is going to be reconnected. The water element is greatly emphasized. As a part of this lake chain, the waterscape in our site needs fixing. Traditionally, the waterscape is more like a finger. The buildings are located along the water. The water bank and the docks were the center of the public activities. In our site, this traditional thing is rare. In some fishing villages nearby our site, it is well preserved. In the dock area, some problems need fixing. Firstly, the water quality is quite unsatisfied. The supporting infrastructures are needed, such as sewage treatment. A large brown field is vacant in the north part. According to the observation, the activities are limited in the dock area. The situation of water from dwelling area is similar with the dock. The canals are not able to provide domestic water now. Rarely could we find the public spaces in this area. Moreover, the traffic condition is terrible in terms of the road capacity and parking lots. Some illegal buildings occupy the canal bank. The spontaneous development of the street market leaves several problems. The vendors occupying make the road crowded, which is definitely a nightmare for the vehicles, bikes, and the pedestrian. In the further development, we would like to choose street market and waterfront area as specific sites. About the street market, the function should be preserved in order to meet the basic needs of the locals. There are three main adjustments. First, the road section should be improved to solve the chaos problem. Then, one or two indoor markets of big size are going to be set up to integrate the vendors. Radically, the whole street is going to be pedestrian area. The waterfront area owns traditional buildings and typology, which are worth of preservation. Sewage treatment is strongly suggested. Moreover, the waterscape is going to be revived to create a public space. Similar with the street market, these areas will be pedestrian only. This is all of our video. Thanks for watching.